Hi everyone, welcome to AHR's IAS Institute. We are back again with the important questions for prelims 2020. Let's begin. Question number 1. This biodiversity hotspot is an integral part of the Nilgiri Biosphere Reserve. It is bounded by protected area network of Nagarhol and Bandipur of Karnataka in the northeast and on the southeast by Mudumalai of Tamil Nadu. Which of the following wildlife sanctuary, national park or reserve is mentioned in the above statement? A. Periyar National Park. B. Parambikulam Tiger Reserve. C. Vayanad Wildlife Sanctuary. D. Silent Valley National Park. And the correct answer is C. Vayanad Wildlife Sanctuary. It's an animal sanctuary in Vayanad, Kerala, in India. It has an extent of 4 ranges, namely Sultan Baitri, Muthanga, Kurichiyat, and Tholpetti. Established in 1973, it is part of the Deccan Plateau and the vegetation is predominantly of the South Indian moist deciduous teak forest. Also, the sanctuary has pastures of the West Coast semi-evergreen trees. It is the second largest one in the state of Kerala and was brought under the Project Elephant in 1991-92. Vayanad district in particular has the largest population of Adivasis in Kerala. Please note, Vayanad Wildlife Sanctuary is one of the safest havens for different species of vultures in the white trumpet vultures and the red-headed vultures. It is in news recently because the Western Ghats Nilgiri subcluster, including all of the sanctuary, is under consideration by the World Heritage Committee for selection as a World Heritage Site. Though not a tiger reserve, Vayanad houses the maximum number of tigers in the state, with an estimated population ranging between 75 and 80 individuals. Next question. Consider the following statements. Number 1. The responsibility of the administration of enemy properties was handed over to the Department of Military Affairs. Number 2. The term enemy has been defined under the Enemy Property Act as a country and its citizens that committed external aggression against India. Select the correct answer using the codes given below. A. One only. B. None. C. Two only. Or D. Both. And the correct answer is C. 2 only. The reason the first statement is incorrect is because the responsibility of the administration of enemy properties was handed over to the custodian of enemy property for India, which is an office under the central government, Ministry of Home Affairs. The expanded definition of the term enemy subject and enemy firm under enemy property Amendment and Validation Act 2017 include that the legal heir and successor of an enemy, whether a citizen of India or a citizen of a country which is not an enemy, and the succeeding firm of an enemy firm, irrespective of the nationality of its members or partners. It prohibits Indian citizens who are legal heirs of enemies from inheriting enemy property and brings them within the definition of enemy. What is enemy property? So basically, when nations go to war, they often seize the properties in their countries of the citizens and corporations of the enemy country. Properties that are seized under these circumstances are referred to as alien properties or enemy properties. Next question. Number 3. Which of the following statements is or are correct? Number 1. Comptroller and Auditor General of India is appointed by the President of India for a period of 6 years or up to the age of 65 years. Number 2. She or he can be removed by the President on same grounds as in the same manner as a judge of the Supreme Court. CAG is the Chairman of the Public Accounts Committee of the Parliament. Select the correct answer using the codes given below. A. 1 and 2 only. B. 2 and 3 only. C. 1 and 3 only. D. 1, 2, 3. Correct answer is A. 1 and 2 only. The reason the third statement is incorrect is because CAG acts as a guide, friend and philosopher of the Public Accounts Committee of the Parliament. And please note that the chairman is appointed by the Speaker of the Lok Sabha. Since 1967, the chairman of the committee is selected from the opposition by convention. Article 148 provides for an independent office of the CAG. He is the head of the Indian Audit and Accounts Department. Under Article 149 of the Constitution empowers the Parliament to prescribe the duties and powers of the CAG, and accordingly the CAG's Duties, Powers and Conditions of Service Act 1971 was enacted. Removal of CAG requires a resolution to be passed to the effect by both the Houses of the Parliament with special majority, either on the ground of proved misbehavior or incapacity. CAG is not eligible for further office either under the Government of India or any state after she ceases to hold his office. The redacted pricing report of the Comptroller and Auditor General of India is an acquisition of 36 Rafale fighter jets from France was tabled in Parliament, came under the Supreme Court's observation. Redaction is a selection or adaption by obscuring or removing sensitive information from a document prior to publication. Next question. Number 4. Which of the following is or are the effects of eutrophication? Number 1. Loss of freshwater lakes. Number 2. New species invasion. Number 3. Loss of coral reefs. Number 4. Harmful algal blooms. Number 5. Shellfish poisoning. Choose the correct answer using the codes given below. A. 1, 2, 3, 4 only. B. 2, 3, 5 only. C. 1 and 4 only. D. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, which means all of the above are correct. Correct answer is D. All of the above are correct. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 are all correct. Eutrophication is when a body of water becomes overly enriched with minerals and nutrients which induce excessive growth of algae. This process may result in oxygen depletion of the water body because as the algae die, they compose and the nutrients contained in the organic matter are converted into inorganic form by the microorganisms. The decomposition process consumes oxygen, which reduces the concentration of dissolved oxygen. This disrupts the normal functioning of the ecosystem, causing a variety of problems such as lack of oxygen needed for fish and shellfish to survive. This is natural eutrophication. Nutrient enrichment of lakes by human activities leads to cultural eutrophication. Land runoff supplies more nutrients such as phosphates and nitrates, along with extra nutrients are also supplied by treatment plants, also supplied by fertilizers, and they're also supplied by farms, including fish farms, as well as untreated sewage in many countries. Question number 5. Consider the following statements. Number 1. Fauna in the steppe biome are protected from chillness by the presence of thick cuticle and epidermal hair or fur. Number 2. In the Mediterranean climate type, one finds trees with small broad leaves and xerophytic plants. Select the correct answer using the codes given below. A. Both. B. None. C. One only. D. Two only. And the correct answer is D. Two only. The reason why the first statement is incorrect is because it is the tundra biome where one finds animals with thick cuticle and epidermal hair or fur. Also here, mammals have a large body size with small tail and ears to avoid the loss of heat from the surface. Mediterranean climate is the temperate deciduous biome here. Plants are in a continuous struggle against heat, dry, excessive evaporation and prolonged droughts. Therefore, they are xerophytic, meaning drought tolerant. Fire is an important hazardous factor in this ecosystem and the adaptation of the plants enable them to regenerate quickly after being burnt. Next question. Number 6. This dance form is attributed to the 15th century Bhakti movement scholar and Saint Mahapurush Srimanta Sankardev, and it was recognized as a classical dance by Sangeet Natak Academy of India in 2000. The key characteristic of this dance form is that it is accompanied by musical compositions called Borgeets. Which of the following dance form is mentioned above? A. Odissi. B. Manipuri. C. Mohiniyattam. Or D. Satriya. And the correct answer is D. Satriya. Satriya Nritya has originated in the eastern state of Assam It is a dance drama performance art with origins in the Krishna-centered Vaishnavism monasteries of Assam. A key musical instrument that accompanies a Satriya performance are kols, two-faced asymmetrical drum quite different from the rest of India, played with fingers. The dance form encompasses the principle of Sangeet Ratnakara of Shankardeva. The Sangeet Ratnakara of Shankardeva complements his Bhakti Ratnakara, which traces the Upanishads, Bhagavad Gita, Yoga and Vedanta themes, the ethical values such as non-violence, ahimsa, truthfulness, satya and others, thus premising a theological foundation to Satriya. Next question, number 7. Florianopolis Declaration is related to the conservation of which of the following? A. Biodiversity hotspots, B. Sumatran rhinoceros, C. Siberian ibex, or D. None. The correct answer is none of the above. The Florianopolis Declaration concluded that the purpose of the International Whaling Commission is the conservation of whales, and that they would now safeguard the marine mammals in perpetuity and will allow the recovery of all whale populations to pre-industrial whaling levels. Next question, number 8. Which of the following statements is or are correct? Number 1. The jurisdiction of Lokpal extends only to Member of Parliament and officials of the Union Government under groups A, B, C and D. Number 2. Lokpal and Lokayukta does not have superintendence over any investigation agency. Number 3. Lokpal and Lokayukta and the members are appointed by the President, but they are removed by Chief Election Commissioner. Choose the correct answer using the codes given below. A. 1 and 2 only. B. 1, 2, 3, C, 2 and 3 only, D, none. Correct answer is none. None of them are correct. The first statement is incorrect because the jurisdiction of Lokpal extends to anyone who is or has been Prime Minister or a Minister in the Union Government or a Member of Parliament as well as officials of the Union Government under groups A, B, C and D. The second statement is also incorrect because power of superintendence and direction over any investigation agency, including the CBI, for cases referred to them by Lokpal. Please note, members are selected High Power Selection Committee comprising the Prime Minister, the Speaker of the Lok Sabha, the Leader of the Opposition Party, the Chief Justice of India, if not available then his nominee, and an eminent jurist nominated by President. The President will appoint the recommended names. This is important from prelims provisions, so please be careful here. Also an exception for PM is that the Act does not allow a Lokpal inquiry if the allegation against the PM relates to international relations, external and internal security, public order, atomic energy and space. Complaints against the PM are not to be probed unless the full Lokpal bench considers the initiation of inquiry and at least two-thirds of the members approve it. Such an inquiry against the PM, if conducted, is to be held in camera, and if the Lokpal comes to the conclusion that the complaint deserves to be dismissed, the records of the inquiry are not to be published or made available to anyone. The reason the third statement is incorrect is because the chairperson or any member shall be removed from his office by order of the President on grounds of misbehavior after the Supreme Court. For that, a petition has to be signed by at least 100 members of the Parliament. Lokpal and Lokayukta Act 2013 establishes Lokpal for the Union and Lokayukta for the states to inquire into allegations of corruption against certain public functionaries. Next question, number 9. National ambient air quality standards includes which of the following pollutants? Number 1, nickel. Number 2, ammonia. Number 3, ozone. Number 4, arsenic. Number 5, benzopyrene. Number 6, PM10. Select the correct answer using the codes given below. A. 1, 2, 3, 4 only. B. 3, 4, 5, 6 only. C. 5 and 6 only. D. All. And the correct answer is all. Central Pollution Control Board set up National Ambient Air Quality Standards in the year 2009. Air Prevention and Control of Pollution Act empowers Central Pollution Control Board to set up standards for the quality of air. Last question. Which of the following statements is or are correct? Ways and Means Advances is a temporary loan facility given by IMF to all the central government of the world for a period of 180 days. Number 2, if the Ways and Means Advances is extended for more than 180 days, it will be treated as an overdraft and the interest rate on overdrafts would be 2% more than the actual interest rate. Select the correct answer given below. A. 1 only. B. 2 only. C. Both. D. None. The correct answer is D. None. All the above statements are incorrect. The first statement is incorrect because the Ways and Means Advance is a loan facility from the RBI for 90 days to the center and state governments as a banker to the government. The second statement is incorrect because government has to vacate the facility after 90 days. The limits for WMA are mutually decided by the RBI and the Government of India. If the WMA is extended for more than 90 days, it will be treated as an overdraft. When the WMA limit is crossed, the government can avail funds throughout the overdraft facility. Overdrafts are not allowed beyond 10 consecutive working days. The interest rate on overdrafts would be 2% more than the repo rate. The government increased the ceiling on its temporary loan facility with the Reserve Bank of India by 60% to tide over the cash flow mismatch in FY21 expected from higher spending to combat the spread of COVID-19. That's all for today. Thank you for watching us. Please like, comment and share. Subscribe to our YouTube channel. Follow us on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram. All the best. We'll be back soon.